I'm Lawrence Drzal. I'm a University Distinguished Professor of Chemical Engineering and Material Science in the College of Engineering at Michigan State University. I'm a Michigan native. I grew up in Detroit, and I had spent about 10 years with the Air Force in Dayton, Ohio, and that's where I learned about this fantastic material that was allowing aerospace vehicles to be lighter and perform better. And this material is called a composite material. It's a combination of certain types of fibers. They can be glass, they can be carbon, combined with different plastics. And the fibers are chosen because of their ability to provide a high degree of stiffness and strength. And the plastics are like the glue that holds everything together. So when I came to Michigan State, actually the dean at the time said that really what we needed is the ability to focus on transitioning that technology from aerospace to durable goods. So automobiles, trucks, windmill blades, and so forth, and be able to make those so they perform as well, but are much lower in cost. And through collaboration with my colleagues in engineering and chemistry, physics, packaging, for example, we put together a center that focuses on fiber-reinforced polymer composites. The opportunity came up a few years ago through a new federal program called the NNMIs. It was to set up a national network of manufacturing institutes. This is really focused on addressing issues related to what it takes to take technology and move it into the manufacturing arena. Because of our proximity to the auto companies, our history with working with the auto companies, we have the responsibility for fiber-reinforced polymer composites in vehicles. These fiber-reinforced polymer composites that we're interested in can further lighten the vehicle without compromising, for example, safety. And by lightweighting the vehicle, we can then improve its efficiency. And you'll be able to get trucks with 40 or 50 miles per gallon efficiency, passenger vehicles with the same thing, and yet provide the crashworthiness and durability that you expect in an automobile. The area of materials are kind of the foundation for really anything that is done in the sciences, in engineering, and the continued investment in support of that area and growth of that area, I think, is critical, not only for MSU, but also for the state and the country.